Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. Today we are talking about descriptive programming in UFT. In UFT, there is an IDE to create and manage test scripts for test automation. This can be used to develop structure-related and modular tests, which I have stored as functions in the script. In this script, objects are identified via descriptive programming without having to use an object repository. Normally, this repository would be used for object management, but it is empty. So I have not stored any objects in it. In fact, they are only passed through these variables. Since we access them more often, but ultimately stay on the same page, I don't have to redefine them for each function, or for each access, but can simply pass the values for the respective action. I also wanted to discuss the test data, which is already maintained in the IDE as a proprietary Excel file in the table surge item table. As a parameter, we have managed the test parameter table search item with three values: UFT1, UFTAI, and UFT descriptive programming to be searched for in the test. Our test is therefore executed three times with different values. How does a test work? The individual values of the table search item are read out with the data table value command and stored in the inSearchItem variable. This information is then transferred to the browser search function, which enters the corresponding data in the search field of the search engine after the browser has been started with the search engine. In the browser web button click function, UFT executes a click on the search button so that the search result is then displayed in the browser. The clean browser state function then resets the browser state and closes the browser to perform the next search. No comprehensive checks are carried out in this small test example. In our video, we want to concentrate on descriptive programming. Of course, the script can easily be extended accordingly. This sequence is executed three times in succession, as we have three search dates in our table. I will now execute the test script once. So, the browser is called up. The search value is transferred to this text field. UFT clicks on the search button. Then the search result is displayed. Then back is clicked again. The browser is closed and reopened. UFT then runs this test two more times with different search values. Now you can look at the test result. And lo and behold, we have three iterations. Here is iteration 1, which refers to row 1 from the Excel table, up to the third iteration. In the report, we can easily see what happens. Launching the browser, setting the search string, synchronizing for the display to click the button which then executes the search, going back once and closing the browser once, all three times in a row. We have already established that our test is very simple, and strictly speaking, it doesn't really check anything. That's why I've now extended the script again to include a function that checks whether the text entered appears as the default value at the top of the following page after clicking on the search button. To do this, the page title must be formed at runtime from the search engine name combined with the search value from the inSearchItem variable and passed to the inPageNewItem variable. Our new function, checkDefaultText, now checks whether the page title contains the information from our new variable pageNewItem. If this page title is present, the test is successful. If this object is successfully identified via exist with a waiting time of 3 seconds, the function value is set to true, which corresponds to the test result pass. If the page title is not found within 3 seconds, the function is terminated. As the function is submitted with false, the function value in this case would be false, which corresponds to the test result fail. In this case, this would lead to a fatal status, so that the test is terminated immediately by UFT. In the successful case, I would set a highlight on this function. As a result, it would also exit the function with a true, and write a pass, and run the whole thing three times. I'll run this now so that you can see how it works. So, now UFT enters the value that I am looking for. Now, this also appears here at the top of the page title, which UFT now checks. The two other tests also contain the corresponding page titles in which the search texts are located. The second test also has a customized page title. Now we are already at the third test, and then UFT closes the browser cleanly. Now we can take another look at the test results here and see how nicely UFT has done the report. Here is our query whether the page title is correct with the past test result. The default is present in search box, and then UFT has made a highlight, which is not listed here, and is followed by a back and close. This log sequence is found 3 times in the log, as we also have 3 test iterations. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our ISTQB, ITK, X-ray, and TestRail certified QA experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.